Welcome back to Bible Club. Let's pray the Lord's Prayer together to start Bible Club. And remember, we pray the Lord's Prayer because this is how Jesus taught us to pray. So, let's pray together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And do not lead us into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Hi, Lynn. I'm sure glad the bus was late.
You are late, too. I thought maybe you weren't coming to school today.
Well, I forgot to bring out the trash, and my mom made me come back to do it.
You forgot last week, too.
I know. My dad said I'd forget my head if it wasn't screwed onto my neck.
But, Lucy, you remember the important stuff. Like when you are going to Cedar Point, and you never forget my birthday.
Ha, that's because you remind me of it about 100 times.
Hey, you helped me with an idea. Miss Catherine asked me to introduce the focus verse today. Here's a question. How will you remember the things about God you learned at Bible Club?
For a start, I have my verse passport, and that reminds me about God and how to pray to Him.
Good idea!
And I have my memory verse coloring book that I have in my backpack, and when I read those verses, I remember things I learned about God.
Yes! And here's a super promise from the Bible. Do a drum roll, Lucy.
Oh.
The Holy Spirit will teach you all things and will remind you of everything I have said to you. John 14, verse 26.
Wow, that is a super promise.
Just when you need it, the Holy Spirit, your live-inside friend, will teach you and help you remember how to live for Jesus.
Len, I am going to watch how he teaches me, even when Bible Club is finished. And I'm going to go to vacation Bible school and Sunday school, too, this summer to keep on learning. Well, wait, Len, you'll probably be a Bible Club teacher when you grow up.
I think you will, too. It's time to start the Bible Club story.
Yeah.
See you later, Lucy.
Every tongue confess that Jesus.
last week, we talked about Ascension, which was the day, 40 days after Jesus rose from the dead, that he ascended, went up into heaven to be with God the Father. And you may remember that Jesus told his disciples a few things before he ascended into heaven. And one of those things that he told them was to wait and then to go. So what were the disciples supposed to wait for? Well, that is actually our focus verse for today. It comes from John chapter 14, verse 26. And the whole thing says, "But the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you all things and will remind you of everything I have said to you." So Jesus told the disciples this, and if we read it again, just the part that's underlined, "But the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, will teach you all things and will remind you of everything I have said to you." What does that sound like? Sounds like a promise. So Jesus promised that the Holy Spirit, his Spirit, would be given to the disciples. And that is what they were supposed to wait for before they were going to go out and tell everyone about Jesus and what he did. They were supposed to wait. And that is our true story for today. This is how we're going to end Bible Club for this year, is talking about this Holy Spirit that Jesus gave to his disciples and promised to give us as well. So when the day of Pentecost arrived, Pentecost, which was 10 days after the ascension, Jesus went up to heaven, and 50 days after Jesus rose from the dead, the disciples were all gathered together. And they were praising God and worshiping, kind of like a church service. And they were doing this together because they were waiting together. They were waiting for the Holy Spirit. And then suddenly, there was a sound like a violent rushing wind that came from heaven, and it filled the whole house where they were staying. And then tongues of fire, like little flames, appeared on the disciples' heads, above their heads. And they all began to speak in different languages. And then they went outside and they spoke to all the people that were outside in their own languages. And the people that were outside, they started to look around at each other and talk to each other. And they said, "Wow, these people, they might have had a little bit too much to drink." That's what the reason why they thought they were making all this noise was because maybe they had had too much to drink. But then some other people said, "Well, that's probably not true that they had too much to drink, because it was pretty early in the morning." So then Peter began to talk. He began to preach to the people. He gave them a sermon. And he was telling them about Jesus. And he was saying to them of Jesus's Spirit that's been given to them. And he was telling them all about how God had been faithful to them and to the Israelites, and that Jesus was the Messiah, and that he came And he came to take our sins and our punishment on him. And that he had risen. He rose back to life and he defeated sin. And now he's back with God the Father in heaven. And he's ruling and he will come back. And so Peter is sharing all of this with all the people that are around. And he's sharing it in their language so that they can understand. Now, Peter and the other disciples, they didn't study these languages. It was the Holy Spirit that appeared as a flame that entered into their hearts and made it possible for them to speak in these other languages. Oh, and all these people, they were so amazed at what Peter was saying. And they said to him, What can we do? What can we do to be a part of God's kingdom? And Peter told them, repent and be baptized. And this is what Jesus had told them to do, to wait for the Holy Spirit, and now they have it, and then to go and to baptize people and to make disciples, followers of Jesus from all over the world. So he told them, Peter said, all you have to do is say you're sorry for your sins, for not obeying God, and then you'll get baptized so that you have the mark of being a new person, a new creation, being made alive in Jesus. So people came and they got baptized. And they continued to talk to each other and talk about Jesus. And they got together and shared all of these things. And more and more people heard about Jesus and became Christians and gave their life to Jesus. It's amazing. The Bible says that on this day, this one day, there were 3,000 people that became Christians, that gave their lives to Jesus, that said, Jesus, you died on the cross for me because you love me. And therefore, I'm going to live for you. 3,000 people in one day. And then from there, the church just keeps growing. And in the Bible, we read about other people that become Christians, that then spread the gospel and the good news of Jesus all over the world. It's amazing that back then, in this day where they didn't have cell phones, they didn't have email, so many people still heard about Jesus because of the power of the Holy Spirit. See, the Holy Spirit is a gift. It's God's Spirit, Jesus' Spirit, that can be with us here on this earth as we live and try to live for God and deal with the hurt and the pain and the sin of this world. The Holy Spirit helps us to do what God wants because we can't do it on our own. That is the whole point of why Jesus came, because we cannot do it on our own. But if you have the Holy Spirit, then he can help you. The verse says, the advocate. That's a word in the Bible that is used to describe the Holy Spirit. An advocate means someone that's standing up for you, someone that's on your team, that is rooting for you, that is going to defend you and speak up for you. And we have that in the Holy Spirit, the same Spirit that Jesus had when he was alive on earth. The same Spirit is now ours, can be ours. The Holy Spirit can be our live inside friend if you believe in Jesus, in what he did, in all the promises. I put up on the board, you'll probably see it's very messy up here, I put up all of the promises that we have learned this entire year. From last semester with God knows and God is near and God speaks, God answers, God keeps, God forgives, God protects. And then also the promises that we learned from these past couple weeks that Jesus said, because I live, you will live also. The Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. And remember, see, your king comes to you, righteous and having salvation, gentle and riding on a donkey. Friends, all of these promises have come true. And therefore, we can have faith. We can trust that the promises that haven't come true yet, that Jesus said that he will come back in the same way that he left, that he will send you his Holy Spirit, you can trust that these promises will also come true if you put your faith and your trust in Jesus Christ. Because like our theme verse for the whole year says, that all of these promises that God has given, they are yes in Christ. Not yes if, not yes maybe, but just yes, period. If you believe in what Jesus did, he will send you his Holy Spirit. And like Len and Lucy were talking about, one of the jobs of the Holy Spirit is to remind us of the things that we've learned, so that you don't have to be stressed out, that you think, oh, well, what if I don't do the right thing? You can trust that in the moment, in the time when you have to make a decision, the Holy Spirit will whisper to you in your mind and in your heart and will say, this is the way you should go. And then you can say, oh yeah, I remember that. I remember those promises and the words that God and Jesus gave in the Bible. And I can trust that if I follow the Holy Spirit and if I do this, then I will be blessed, because God is in charge and he loves me. He wants what's best for me. God is so good. And everything that he's done, everything that we've learned about, is him showing us how much he loves us. He doesn't want to let us go. We belong to him. We're his children. And he wants us to be with him. So that's why he sent Jesus. That's why we get the opportunity to believe in Jesus. It's amazing. And then we have the Holy Spirit, and then we can go and we can tell everybody else about Jesus, about this amazing gift, and give them the opportunity to believe. And when you give other people that opportunity, it's like another way of saying thank you to God, of saying thank you so much for saving me. I'm so thankful that I'm going to go and I'm going to tell other people so that they have the opportunity to be close with God. I am so thankful that you have been watching these videos, that we have been learning about God and his promises together. The Holy Spirit will remind us of these things, but it's also really nice because we have the church here on earth and other Christians that also can remind us of these things. So I encourage you that if you don't go to church, if you're not a part of a church, to try to find one. Maybe you can talk to your grown-ups and see if they'd be interested in going to church. Or there's many other things too, like on YouTube and online, that can help you learn more about God, because you don't just learn everything about God and then stop. Nobody knows everything. God is so big that no matter how old somebody is, they do not know everything about God. So we never stop learning, and we never stop trying to be more like Jesus. But you can rest knowing that if you believe in Jesus, you've invited him into your heart, you are saved. And all of these promises are yes for you. Isn't that incredible? Praise God.
I'm gonna take God's promises and hide them in my heart, so I won't forget.
Time to close Bible Club for the last time for this school year. Again, I want to thank you for being here, for tuning in to Bible Club. And again, I want to encourage you to look for a church, or if there's a vacation Bible school in your neighborhood, to try to sign up for that this summer. There's so many amazing promises that God has given in the Bible that give us so much peace and comfort. And all you gotta do is read about it. And if you can't read yet, then you can have someone else read it to you, or you can listen to it online. The Holy Bible, this is another one of God's gifts that help us to know about him, to help us to feel close to him. The Holy Bible is God's words to us. It's like a letter written just for you, that you can know how much God loves you and what he's done for you. So keep reading the Bible. Never stop reading the Bible. Every day it's good to read the Bible, because every day you hear things from TV and from the world, but those things aren't always true. So it's good to read something every day that you can trust is the truth. And if you don't have a Bible and you'd like one, the Kids Life Bible Club's office information is at the end of this video. And I would love for you to give us a call or send us an email, and we will definitely see what we can do to get you a Bible, because God's words are for you. And he wants you to know them. So if you will you close your eyes and fold your hands, and then we can end this last Bible Club together. And know that I'll be praying for you throughout the summertime, and that we pray that in the fall, for this next coming school year, that we'll be able to have Bible Club in person, and we can talk about God's amazing promises together. So let's pray. Dear God, thank you so much for your word, for the Bible. We would be lost without it, God. You show us, you tell us how much you love us and what you've done for us. And you give us wisdom and hope and peace. And something solid, God. You are the solid rock. And in this world where things change so often, we need that solid rock. So thank you, God. Thank you for being faithful. Thank you for loving us. God, please help us, remind us with your Holy Spirit what it is that we need to do to show your love to the people around us. And God, please forgive us for when we don't show that love. I pray all of this in your Son's name, who saved us by his work of living a perfect life and dying on the cross and rising back again. We pray all of this in his name. Amen. I'm going